The former headquarters of the Greater London Council was to have been transformed into a five-star hotel and conference centre. But with the collapse of the ambitious plan, shareholders can expect to lose their investment of up to £50 million, £20 million of it a deposit paid to the building's owner, the London Residuary Body. The consortium behind the scheme were staying tight-lipped today.
County Hall Development Group Chairman David Jackson agreed to be interviewed by us but later changed his mind. The group have blamed the bad state of the property market and delays in planning permission for the failure of their project.
The consortium's financial crisis surfaced last week with a report that tried to get the minimum purchase price of £185 million substantially reduced, something which the London Residuary Body said was unacceptable. The former leader of the GLC is glad the scheme's failed.
This means now nothing can be done permanently with that building before the next election. So it will still be there for the next Labour government to use as a headquarters for the new body we're going to create to bring together regional services for London. Also, a lot of people who thought they could make a profit out of Londoners have actually got a very nasty cold. I'm delighted.
The London Residuary Body rejected Livingstone's suggestion County Hall should be used for the homeless during the winter. They plan to press ahead for planning permission.
The scheme is a very fine scheme, and I very much hope that we can resurrect it and find someone else who will now complete it.
But the Waterloo Community Development Group, whose plan for County Hall came second, tonight renewed their call for all agencies who have anything to do with running London to be housed on the site. Now it looks as if the Environment Secretary will be left to make a final decision. Mark Wadsworth, Thames News.